नमस्ते व्यूअर्स एंड लिसनर्स, माइसेल्फ डॉक्टर ब्रह्मधर शर्मा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर कुमार भट्ट, श्री शिरडी साईं बाबा आयुर्वेदिक कॉलेज रेनवाल जयपुर। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू अवर लास्ट टॉपिक न्यू बॉर्न एग्जामिनेशन एज पार्ट सेकेंड। नेक्स्ट वी कम ऑन गैस्ट्रेशनल एज असेसमेंट। We can assess it at two stages, at antenatal assessment and assessment after the birth. First we see antenatal assessment. What are the clinical method to assess the gestational age of newborn? The first one is last menstrual period. In the diagram we can see the Nagel's rule, which has two example. If the patient has LMP December 18, 2013, then subtract 3 from months, add 7 in days and add 1 in years. So the EDD is 25 August 2014. In next example, this is other method and answer will be same. You can add 9 months 7 days in the first days of last menstrual period. It is very interesting and popular method from the last several years. Next method come, that is height of fundus. In next picture you can see the assessment start after first trimester, because in first trimester there is slight development of fundus, so there is difficulty in assess the timing. But after 16 weeks it is easy. At the nevus level it comes in 24 weeks, and at the GP sternum 36 weeks, and again down in last time of antenatal period about 40 weeks. So we can assess the gestational age by fundal examination. Next, the fetal movement, or we can say quickening start about 18 weeks of age. When you ask the patient that fetal movement start or not, if answer is yes, then it is 100% sure that it is minimum 18 week old. Next is fetal heart sound. You can assess it by stethoscope after 16 weeks. So these are some clinical methods to assess antenatal assessment of gestational age. Next, some biochemical assessment in which amniotic fluid assessment. First one is creatinine level. It is more than 2 mg per dl at gestational age of 36 weeks. It increased with maturity. Next, lecithin and sphingomyelin ratio. It should be equal to or more than 2. It indicates lung maturity. in cytological examination, vaginal wall cytology, it shows presence of superficial cells at term maturity, and amniotic fluid cytology, there are organophilic squamous cell at the term level. And very popular method is radiological. 3 ultrasonography in total antenatal period is recommended by a gynecologist, in which several criteria are used for assessment of gestational age. X-ray is old method for diagnose ossification centers. The ossification center of lower femoral appears at 36 week and upper tibial at 38 weeks. Then assessment of gestational age after birth. The score which is used name Ballard score, which has 12 points, 6 points from physical maturity and 6 points from neurological maturity. First we see physical maturity. The skin, this score has minus 1 to 5 marking. In last we will see the table. First we are discussing the one by one points. Skin, in very preterm it is plethoric like very red, transparent, oily, shiny. Lanugos are abundant about 30 weeks of gestational, 27 to 30 week of gestational. Before it and after it, it disappears. Plantar surface, you can see the picture, the first picture, first plantar surface is for preterm baby and next for term. There are less ridges in the plantar surface of preterm. Next, when we see breast nodules in preterm, the size of breast nodule is less than 5 millimeter and term more than 5 millimeter, and areola is less developed. You can see in this picture. Next, external ear recoiling is very poor in preterm and coiling is very good in term. It shows elasticity of cartilage is less in preterm. Eyes is not so much open in very preterm children as compared to term babies. Next, genital females. Labia majora is widely opened and clitoris hypertrophied in preterm baby. In male genitals, there are less rugosities in preterm and undescendent testis or one descendant testis in preterm babies. Next come on neuromuscular maturity. First we discuss about posture. What is the normal posture of a term baby? That is, all extremities are flexed. You can see in this picture, the right one is from term baby and left one is for preterm baby. You can see the scoring system minus 1 to 5. When we go for minus 1 for preterm stages, the posture is hypotonic. All extremities are not flexed, but as we come as term gestational age, all extremities are flexed, just like in utero pattern. Next we see square window test. It is for checking joint mobility. It is very important. The concept should be clear. If you see in preterm, there is inability to touch the palm to the forearm. So the square window angle is maximum in preterm. As we go to the term stage, it turn into the 0 degree angle. There should not be the square window. So joint mobility is more as term gestation age arrived, because the baby should pass to the narrow passage, so joint mobility should be more for normal delivery. Next we come on popliteal angle. You can see in this picture, as popliteal angle is less than 90% in term gestational age. As we come to preterm stage, it goes to 180 degree. 180 degree means the whole leg of the baby will be stretched straight, then popliteal angle will be 180 degree. You can see this picture. Next we come on arm recoil test. In it we should open the child's forearm from flex condition to straight condition, then relax. It will turn again in flex condition. It shows arm recoiling is good in term gestational age and arm recoiling is poor in preterm stage. Next important sign comes scarf sign, in which you see when you try to cross the child arm from one side to another side, the elbow will cross the mediastinum in preterm baby. It will not cross the mediastinum in term baby. This is the picture. Next, very simple, heel to ear. The heel touches the ear very easily in preterm baby. Not possible in term baby. It is the neuromuscular maturity examination. Both physical and neuromuscular examinations are very important in Ballard score. This is the picture of Ballard score. In first you can see neuromuscular maturity, the 6 points. It is very clear one by one. In skin, and last you can see the score. The score is 0 at 24 week of gestation, when gestational age increase 2 points, the score increase 5 points. Then it is 20 at 32 weeks, 40 at 40 weeks, and 50 at 44 weeks. That is maximum. Then other interesting topic is neonatal reflexes. What are the neonatal reflexes? They also known as developmental, primary or primitive reflexes. They consist of autonomic behavior that do not require higher level brain functioning. They can provide information about lower motor neuron functions and muscle tone. They are often protective and disappear as higher level motor function emerges. Rooting reflex. When you touches the finger beside the child's mouth, the child turns his mouth toward your finger. This is called rooting reflex. Onset around 28 week of gestational, well established at 32 to 34 weeks, disappear at 3 to 4 months of age. Next comes sucking reflex. Its onset around 28 week of gestation, well established 32 to 34 weeks of gestational age, and disappear around 12 months. When you enter your little finger in child's mouth, it try to suck your finger. This is called sucking reflex. The important thing is that rooting, sucking and sucking swallowing combination is very important for starting breastfeeding in a child. Next very important reflex is Moro reflex. Its onset around 28 week of gestational age and well established at 37 week of gestational age, disappears 6 month of age. When you hold the baby from 30 degree angle from the bed and suddenly drop the baby, in first phase abduction of the arm and extension of the neck, in second phase adduction of the arms and flexion of the trunk. This is the normal tendency before 6 months. Moro significance. An absence of inadequate Moro response on one side, hemiplegia, brachial plexus or clavicle fracture, persistent beyond 5 month of age is indicative severe neurological defect. Next, tonic neck reflex. It has two part, asymmetric tonic neck reflex. Onset 35 week of gestation, well established 4 weeks, disappear after 6 to 7 months of birth. By rotating the infant's head from midline to one side, the infant should respond by extending the arm on the side to which the head is turned and flexing the opposite arm. The lower extremity responds similarly. This is asymmetric tonic neck reflex. Then symmetric tonic neck reflex. At around 6 months after birth, the baby, as it extends its neck, will also extend its arm and at the same time flex its hips and knees, bringing the baby up to into a cat sit position. This is symmetric tonic neck reflex in extension. Conversely, when the baby flex its neck, its hip and knee will extend it so that its bottom will go up into the air. This is called symmetric tonic neck reflex in flexion. The picture is very clear. Gallant reflex onset, 28 week of gestational age, well established 40 weeks of gestational age, disappear about 3 to 4 months. What is this? The infant is held in the ventral suspension with the chest in the palm of the examiner's hand. Firm pressure is applied to the infant's side parallel to the spine in the thoracic area. The response consists of flexion of the pelvis toward the side of stimulus. Palmar gasp. The palmar gasp reflex appear at birth and persists until 5 to 6 months of age when an object is placed in the infant's hand and stroke their palm. The fingers will close and they will gasp it with a palmar gasp. Next, plantar gasp. Just like palmar gasp, a plantar reflex is a normal reflex that involves plantar flexion of the foot. Toes moves away from the shin and curl downward. Next is Babinski sign. This result in a dorsiflexion of the foot. Foot angles toward the shin, big toe curl up. This also occurs in baby under 1 year because of low myelination of corticospinal tract. After 1 year, it is abnormal. Next, stepping reflex. The walking or stepping reflex is present at birth when the sole of their feet touch a flat surface. They will attempt to walk by placing one foot in front of the other. This reflex disappears at 6 weeks due to an increased ratio of leg weight to its strength. Parachute reflex. It usually appears at 8 to 9 months of age when the baby is turned face down toward the mat. The arms will extend as if the baby is trying to catch himself. Next, what are the special senses of a baby? In term newborn, the vision is 6 by 45. It reaches to 6 by 6 at the age of 6 to 7 years. Baby responds to strong light by blinking. Head turned toward diffuse light after 32 weeks of gestational. Show attention or follows moving red ball after 34 weeks of gestation. Pupil reaction to light not present less than 29 to 31 weeks of gestational. These things are normal to newborn baby. What are the method of examination in Ayurveda? In Ayurvedic literature, examination of children, especially newborn child, has been described in detail and well symptomatic. These are some references. Like in Charak Sanhita, there is Jati Sutra Adhyay, Kashyap Sanhita Lakshana Adhyay, Ashtang Sangraha Uttar Tantra, Balok Charaniya Adhyay, Ashtang Hridaya Sharir, Vikrati Vigyaniya Adhyay. These are some places where examination of newborn is written. लक्षण अध्याय इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर फ्रॉम काश्यप संहिता. इन इट फर्स्ट फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन टू नो द लॉन्गेविटी ऑफ अ बेबी, द डिटेल एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ ऑल द मेजर एंड माइनर बॉडी पार्ट्स, प्रपोर्शनेट मेजरमेंट्स विद अंगुली प्रमाण, वॉइस नेचर, दोष डोमिनेंस एंड प्रकृति असेसमेंट इज ऑल्सो देयर. इन अदर रेफरेंसेज देयर आर फिजियोलॉजिकल एक्टिविटी लाइक सकिंग, यूरिनेशन, डेफिकेशन, स्लीप, क्राई एंड स्माइल ऑफ द बेबी. थैंक यू वेरी मच. हियर वी कंप्लीट दिस टॉपिक, एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ न्यू बॉर्न. थैंक यू फॉर लिसनिंग.